Hello everyone, in the video JAP 408, the new Java Simple Web Service, you saw how you can start and use the new Simple Web Server via the command line to serve static files. JAP 408 introduced also a new set of APIs for the server creation and customization. My name is Giuseppe and I'm Senior Software Engineer and Content Creator. In this video I want to show you how you can retrieve a server instance with the new APIs introduced in Java 18. Let's get started. The first thing that I need to do is to check that I have installed Java 18, because the new JAP 408 APIs have been introduced in Java 18. Inside Visual Studio Code, I'm going to open the terminal and type java -- version. Good, I have OpenJDK 18.0.2 installed in my system. Perfect. Now I'm going to create a new Java class and I'm going to call it custom-web-server.java. I'm going to create the main method. Perfect. Now I want to create a new server instance and I'm going to use the create file server method provided by simple file server class under the package com.sun.net.http server. Inside the main method I'm going to write var server equal simple file server. Of course I need to import the package. I'm going to write import com.sun.net.http server dot simple file server. Then here I can write dot create file server. The create file server method needs three parameters: the address, a bind address, the root directory, the directory to serve, and the output level, the log level like info, debug, overbose. So let's declare these three variables. Init socket address, then path, root directory, and then output level. Output level. Perfect. Let's initialize the address variable. Add equal new init socket add. I'm going to put just the port 8080. Perfect. Then the path. I'm going to put path dot off. And for the moment, I'm going to put an empty value. Let me open the terminal again. Let me check the path where I am. Okay. And let's put the path here. Perfect. Then the output level. Output level dot verbose. Perfect. To run the server, I have just to type server.start. Server.start. Good. Now I'm ready to run the server and I'm going to click on the run button. Perfect. So the server has started, but I cannot see any logs. It's not an issue and I'm going to show you in a moment. I'm going to test my custom server using curl. I'm going to type curl http / localhost 8080. Good, the server is working, serving the current directory. Now I'm going back inside the logs and here I can see the logs of my request. Perfect, the server is working as expected. Now I want to show you another thing. Go back inside the Visual Studio Code and in the same level of the custom web server.java, create a new file called index.html. I'm going to put a simple HTML structure, just with the body and just H1 with the string the web server is running. Perfect. Now I'm going to again open the terminal and I'm going to again call my web server with curl, and in this case you can see that my server is automatically serving the index.html file. Of course, I can retrieve the content of the custom web servers just typing localhost 8080 / custom web server.java. See, I can see the content of the custom web server. To stop the server, you can just click on Ctrl plus C. In just a few steps, I've created a new custom simple web service with the new createFile method introduced in Java 18 thanks to the new JEP408 APIs. In the following videos, I'm going to show you how you can use the other APIs introduced with JEP408. Thanks for watching this video, subscribe to my channel to be always updated about new videos that I will upload, and see you in the following video tutorial. Bye!